Have you upgraded to Windows 11 and have some problems? Well, in this video, we're going to look at some fixes you can apply to improve your Windows 11 performance. For a more in-depth look at the subject, be sure to check out the article in the description. Let's start with a common problem users are facing: your system not meeting minimum requirements to upgrade to Windows 11. This will be most common on older hardware that does not have the TPM 2.0. Although Microsoft does not recommend running Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, there are ways to do this. On the screen that shows the requirements error, press Shift and F10 to open up a command prompt. Then type in REGEDIT to open the registry editor. When it opens, navigate to H key, local machine, then system, then setup. On setup, right click and create a new key and call it labconfig and hit enter. In the right pane, you're going to need to create these four D words with a decimal value of 1. You'll need to create bypass TPM check, give it a value of 1, then create bypass CPU check, likewise give it a value of 1, bypass RAM check, and bypass secure boot check, and also value of 1. Then close the registry, close the command prompt, close the wizard. Click on install now. And you should be able to install Windows with no problems then. Next, let's look at what you can do if you cannot activate your copy of Windows 11. Try running the activation troubleshooter first. To do this, open Settings, in System, go to Activation, under Activation State, you should be able to click on Activation Troubleshooter. Run the wizard to solve the problem, then try the activation again. If that does not work, or the activation troubleshooter is not available to you, then I would suggest watching the video we made on how to activate Windows. We will include a link in the description. So if you are unable to drag and drop items to the taskbar, do not feel alone. Windows 11 removed the function in Windows 11. However, you can add it with ease. Go to GitHub and download Windows 11 drag and drop to taskbar fix. Simply download the file, open it, you can then just drag and drop of an open icon that can open the file. Suppose you're dealing with blank widgets, or the widgets are not loading. There are a couple quick things we can do to fix this. First, make sure that you're logged into your Microsoft account. Do this by going to Settings, going to Accounts, and making sure that you're logged in. If that does not work, you can check to see that widgets are enabled. To do that is to just open Settings, go to Personalization, go down to Taskbar, go to Widgets, and make sure that it's toggled on. You can also make sure that Edge is set as your default browser. To do this, go to Settings, then go to Apps, look for Default Apps. Then go to Microsoft Edge and make sure that it is set as your default browser. Also, scroll down to HTML and HTML and make sure that these are also set to Microsoft Edge. Some users are reporting problems with their Microsoft Store. There are a couple things we can try. First, let's run a couple troubleshooters. Go to Settings. In the System tab, go down to Troubleshoot. Click on Other Troubleshooters. We're first going to look for the Windows Update Troubleshooter. Click Run. After that's done, then we are going to look for the Windows Store Apps Troubleshooter. Click on Run. Follow any of the on-screen prompts. When that's done, restart the system and see if this has fixed that problem. We can also try and reset the Windows Store cache. We did a video on how to do this and we'll include a link to it in the description. Many new Windows 11 users have been facing this issue on their computers, especially a laptop. At times, internet speed is comparatively slower than on other devices, like the 5G, Wi-Fi is not working, or it's disconnecting frequently, or it's not detecting Wi-Fi at all, and so on. There are a number of fixes you can try. For instance, run the Network Adapter Troubleshooter. Go to Settings once again. In System, we're looking for Troubleshoot, Other Troubleshooters, and look for the Network Adapter Troubleshooter. Click on Run. Follow any of the on-screen prompts. And also go up to Internet Connections, click Run. Follow the on-screen prompts, then restart your system and see if this helps. Are you experiencing slow startup? It might be because you have too many programs in Windows 11 set to start on startup. The easiest way to fix this is in the Task Manager. We're going to right-click on Start. Go to Task Manager. You're looking for the Startup tab. Look at the programs that are enabled. And if you don't absolutely need this on startup, disable it. Once you've done with this, restart your system and see if your system now starts faster. There have been reports that the printer is not working as well with Windows 11 as it did with Windows 10. There are some fixes. The easiest solution that I can come up with is to uninstall and reinstall the printer drivers. To uninstall the drivers, we're going to go to the Device Manager. Your printer drivers, and then right-click and select Uninstall Device. After that, restart your system. You can let the printer install the drivers automatically, or you can go to the website of your printer and download the latest drivers. If your printer is running slowly, then there are some other things we can try. We did a video on how to improve printer speed, and we'll include a link to it in the description. If you're on a laptop and Windows 11 is draining your battery faster than it did on Windows 10, or any other older operating system, we have a few options to look at. We cover this in a very informative how-to on how to fix battery drain issues, and we'll link that in the description. Microsoft has made it a little different to change the default browser on Windows 11, and that is messing with the regular users. Earlier, it was possible to change the default browser with just one click. It's still possible to do that. However, there are some things that are different now, and it may be a requirement for you to change the browser for each file extension. To do this, go into Settings. Then go into Apps, look for Default Apps. Look for the browser that you want to set as default and click on it. It may be possible at the top to click Set Default to make this alternative browser your default browser. It may also be required for you to go in for the different file types or links and actually set each one of the file types to the browser you want to set it as. After that, restart your system. If you have a low amount of RAM or an older CPU, you might get this high CPU or memory usage issue after installing Windows 11. Most of the victims have such hardware running Windows 11. If you're using Windows 11 and it is showing 100% disk, CPU, and memory usage, then there are some steps we cover in a video that we will link on how to fix this, as Microsoft included a new or revamped File Explorer. Many people are facing different issues with this. One of the most common problems is that it is very slow to open on their computer. You can try and speed up your File Explorer and see if the performance improves, and we offer a video to that that will show you just how to do that. Or you can also re-enable the old Windows 10 File Explorer. To do this, you will need to make some tweaks in the registry. So before you do this, make a backup of your registry, a system restore point, or both. Then open the registry editor. Then navigate to H key current user. Then go to software. Next, go to Microsoft. Then Windows. Then current version. Explorer. Advanced. Look for a D word called separate process. Double click on it and make sure that the value is set to zero. Then click on OK. Then open the Task Manager. Scroll down to find Windows Explorer and click on Restart. Windows 11 unfortunately comes with tons of bloatware, or additional apps that you may not ever need or even find necessary. For example, you can find Netflix, Spotify, Facebook, and so on. If you want to remove these unnecessary programs, then go to Settings, go to Apps, select Installed Apps, and go through the list. Remove the apps that you do not think that you'll need or use. After you're done, restart your system. If you have installed Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, you might get this blank or black screen with a blinking cursor problem. However, you can fix it by removing additional external devices like external hard drives, changing the boot source, etc. If you're having problems of a black screen after the shutdown, then you might need to update your graphics drivers, modify your power management, or a few other things. We did a video on how to do that, and we'll link that one as well in the description. According to some people, Windows 11 is a lot slower than Windows 10. If you feel the same, you can change a few settings before making the decision of downgrading back to Windows 10. You can restrict the number of apps at startup, remove pre-installed apps, enable fast startup, disable visual effects, etc. We offer a wonderful video on tons of steps that you can try to make your system run faster. And as always, we will link that one in the description as well. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.